because I did not have a boyfriend. I wasn't good at it. I didn't know how to do it. If I liked a guy, this is how I'd hit on guys. I'd stand next to them for years. It is not great. It is not good. It does not get you dates. But then, the worst invention, the best invention, the worst invention, the best invention, the worst invention, the best invention, online dating. And I got a fella. And he's good at it. He's a game designer. He makes video games for a living, and it's amazing. But I don't know anything about being in a relationship. He's my first relationship. We got married 10 years ago. And I was 100 when we got married. And so, but the thing is so I still don't, every day I wake up and I'm like, have I broken it? And he's like, no. And we go forth with that. Because all I know about being in a relationship, I know from my cuckoo bird parents, mixed reviews there, not great. And male comics, off and on there too. So, because guys, I've been hearing jokes for 30 years of doing stand-up about being in a relationship. So that's how I know what not to do or what to do is guys telling jokes about their wives and girlfriends, right? And so one of the jokes in the 90s was, women are always asking us what we're thinking about. We're not thinking about anything. Stop asking. I'll tell you if I'm thinking about something. Stop asking. So I never asked my boyfriend who became a husband what he was thinking about. Never did. Never did. Why? Because I was told not to. And then 3 years into our relationship, which means we had been married for a year and a half, we're in the car and he turns to me and says, what are you thinking about? He asked me. And I said, comedy, what are you thinking about? And he said, games. And it was the last time we had that conversation. Because that is all he is thinking about. And that is all I am thinking about. Sometimes male comics are right. Anyway. But he's a game designer, so everything's a game to him. So, like, I don't know. You know when you go to, like, a holiday event or a work event or a family event that you do not want to go to? And you say to your partner, hey, this is not going to be fun. Will you please come with me? He is an adult man who has had short-term relationships and long-term relationships like a person, so he knows how to be in a relationship. And he would always say to me, he's always said, hey, this isn't going to be fun, but please come and I will use you as a pick and it will be more bearable. And I have always said, of course, I would love to be of some use to this relationship. Allow me to be part of the solution. But I never asked him to go because I always thought to myself, well, I don't even fucking want to go to this thing. Why would I bring the guy that I like the best to the thing I don't want to go to? Until about 2 months ago when I had a small, tiny meltdown and I said to him in this tone of voice, please come with me to the thing I don't want to go to. And he looked at me and he goes, of course. Why didn't you just ask? And I said, I didn't want to be a burden. And he did something that I recommend you do if you're ever in a relationship with me. He laughed in my face. He didn't laugh at me. He just laughed. And he goes, I'm pretty sure that's what marriage is. We're a burden on each other. And then he said, because he's a game designer, he said, I got a game. Here's the game, maybe. Every time you think you're being a burden on me, give me a dollar. And every time I think I'm being a burden on you, I'll give you a dollar. And I promise you, we will never need another fucking dollar. We will trade that dollar back and forth for the next 40 years. And I said, well, you are adorable, but that game sounds boring. And he said, well, it's a prototype and we would have to play test it. Because everything's a game. Everything's got a game mechanic. Everything's got a game design. He literally, I get text messages from him from different places. A couple of years ago, got a text message from the grocery store. All it said was, the user interface here is broken. I don't know how long I'll be at the grocery store. So I called him up and I said, what's the user interface at the grocery store? And he says, the line. It should be one line, like at the bank, but it has many lines. So I don't know if I've chosen correctly. I don't know how long it's going to be. And I said, well, I'll be hanging up. But my favorite one was last year. He went to his first ever strip joint. I have been hanging out with dirtbags for 30 years and have been to many strip joints. He had never been to a strip joint before because every other bachelor party he had been to had been a board game bachelor party. Games, good board games, right? Settlers, Ticket to Ride, Pandemic. Get out there. Treat yourself right. Treat yourself right. Here's my current favorite party game. It's called Bring Your Own Book. It's like apples to apples. It's quite nice. And now that unsolicited ad is over, I will continue. Now, So he goes to the strip. He's going to go. I get a text message and it says, hey, I'm in time for the bachelor party. We're going to a strip club. I'm going to go look at boobs. And so I texted him back and I said, well, come home to mine later. Have a good time. And an hour after that, I get a text from him and it says, what game is this? So I called him and I said, it's not a game. It's noodly ladies being noodly. That's the whole game. And he said, oh, no, there's a game here. There's a lot of in-game purchasing going on. Yes, yes, there is. Yes, there is. And then he said, I don't like it. I don't like it. And I said, well, delete the app. Get the fuck out. But he knows things, right? A couple of months ago, we were sitting around. And so we're sitting around. And he says, out of the blue in the living room, hey, you know, sometimes when you're in a relationship for a long time, the mystery can be lost from that relationship. And I just want you to know that I was just staring at you from across the room. And I was thinking to myself, what the fuck is she doing? So you guys, I still got it.